My name is Russo Ingui. I was born in Naples, Italy. My mother's name was Natalie Ingui. I was born on November 4, 1912. When I was 8 years old, my mother and my brothers Tony, Raffaello, Leonardo, Giuseppe, and I got on a ship in the steerage compartment and sailed out to the land of opportunity, America. I was the second oldest in my family. Tony was the oldest, but I was the only one who knew a little English because I had a tutor. I was so excited on the boat, even though it was crowded, because I was finally going to see my father. My mother told me that he left sometime in August in the year 1912, before I was born. When we finally got to the land where the streets were supposedly paved with gold, we had to wait to get checked in at the Great Inspection Hall at Ellis Island. It was so disturbing waiting for the inspection. There were two doctors. One was there to check for physical and mental abnormalities, and the other doctor checked for contagious or infectious diseases. Luckily, none of us had any problems, so we were pulled through right away. Mother had pulled out a letter and that Dad sent us a couple of months earlier. The letter stated that he was at a tenement at 344 East 6th Street, apartment 16. When we got there and opened the door, there he was. It was my father. His name was Gianni. He told us that he had a job as a chauffeur, a person who drives rich people around. He made $12.50 a week. My brothers and I started to work running errands, and we each got $3 a week. My mom worked in a sewing shop making $10 a week, and of course this all happened when I turned 12 in the year 1923. My brother Tony and I stopped working and started going to school because school was compulsory. I got average grades in my classes because I spoke some English. I got B's and C's. Tony got D's and F's because he did not know any English. When we got out of school every day, we ran errands and still made some money. But since school was interfering with our work, we only got 75 cents per week. On weekends, when we got the day off, we went to the dime museum, played marbles, flew kites, spun tops, played kick the can, and played with lead soldiers. In the dime museum, we saw really strange things. There were fire eaters, sword swallowers, fat ladies, midgets, snake charmers, bearded ladies, four-legged chickens, and many more things. Sometimes I just stayed home, listened to jazz, and did many mischievous things on the streets with my brothers and friends. By that time, all my brothers knew how to speak English. Most of the time, we just fooled around on the streets listening to jazz and dancing. The 20s were the times of gaiety and happiness. When we went to the movies to see the moving pictures, it was just people getting bonked on the head with rubber hammers and other funny things. I guess this foolishness was a reaction to World War I and all its horrors. With the invention of the automobile, people could go places and not have to sit in a carriage and smell the horse. What a great invention. The refrigerator took the place of the icebox, so you wouldn't have to get a block of ice every time you wanted to cool your food. Another convenient item invented during this time was the vacuum cleaner to take place of the carpet sweeper and the broom. And last but not least, the radio. With this invention, you could listen to music like jazz. I saved up about $5 so I could buy a radio all for myself. But these were merely just some of the great inventions that were invented in the 20s. Segregation down south was very disturbing. I don't know why whites can't get along with blacks. Of course, I wouldn't know because I'm Italian, which is neither white nor black. It's nothing really big here in New York because most blacks live in the southern states of USA, like Tennessee, Alabama, and Mississippi. One day, we went to the beach. We had fun for a while, but the most horrible thing happened. My father and mother were out in the water. My father went out too far and nobody ever found him again. We all forgot about him in about 6 weeks on account of the fact that none of us except my mother really knew him that well. We all still felt sorrow for my father's death, but we still talked about him. That was the day that I stopped fooling around and on the streets with ghetto kids. My mother found another man to marry, but they had no new children. My new father had the same job as my old father, but made less money. My new father taught me how to gamble by flipping pennies. Some days when I got lucky, I would make about 25 cents. The 20s were the times of gaiety and happiness. When we went to the movies to see the moving pictures, it was just people getting bonked on the head with rubber hammers and other funny things. I guess this foolishness was a reaction to World War I and all its horrors. With the invention of the automobile, people could go places and not have to sit in a carriage and smell the horse. What a great invention. The refrigerator took the place of the icebox so you wouldn't have to get a block of ice every time you wanted to cool your food. Another convenient item invented during this time was the vacuum cleaner to take place of the carpet sweeper and the broom. And last but not least, the radio. With this invention, you could listen to music like jazz. I saved up about $5 so I could buy a radio all for myself. But these were merely just some of the great inventions that were invented in the 20s. Segregation down south was very disturbing. I don't know why whites can't get along with blacks. Of course, I wouldn't know because I'm Italian, which is neither white nor black. It's nothing really big here in New York because most blacks live in the southern states of USA, like Tennessee, Alabama, and Mississippi. One day, we went to the beach. We had fun for a while, but the most horrible thing happened. My father and mother were out in the water. My father went out too far and nobody ever found him again. We all forgot about him in about six weeks on account of the fact that none of us except my mother really knew him that well. We all still felt sorrow for my father's death, but we still talked about him. That was the day that I stopped fooling around on the streets with ghetto kids. My mother found another man to marry, but they had no new children. My new father had the same job as my old father, but made less money. My new father taught me how to gamble by flipping pennies. Some days when I got lucky, I would make about 25 cents.